If you guys are looking for super cheap, fast, and reliable Madden 21 coins, look no further than my sponsor, MuttReserve.com. Coins are currently discounted, guys. They got 24/7 support. They're super awesome to work with. Head on over, use code Poodle for an additional 15% off your order. Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate Team video, guys. And today, I'm going over what you guys need to be doing before Series 2. Series 2 does come out tomorrow, and a Series 2 update or any series update does require some things to be done and some things to be wary of prior to it dropping. Now, the reason for that is just because of how this is pertained to what comes out with it, what is going to be there tomorrow, what new stuff will be out, what stuff will expire, such as trophies. I'll be going over everything in this video, though, guys, so make sure to go down below, like the video up, subscribe to the channel, guys. And for today's Poodle Squad shout out is D-Wade. Shout out to D-Wade for being a part of the Poodle Squad. Thank you so much, man, for showing support each and every day. If you guys want a chance to be shouted out in tomorrow's or later tonight's Poodle Squad, all you gotta do is go down below, like the video, turn the noti bell next to the subscribe button, and of course, comment Poodle Squad down below, and probably be subscribed as well. I'd imagine if you have noti bell on, you're probably subscribed. But guys, let's get into the video and go over everything. So first thing you want to focus on for Series 2, guys. First off, there will be a new max mutt level tomorrow. Now, a new max mutt level will more than likely mean, and in my opinion, probably be level 60. Level 60 is probably what we're looking for in terms of a new max mutt level, because that is what it's been in years past. It goes 50 to 60. Now, what does a new max mutt level entail? New level of packs, like level 52, 54, 56, 58. They'll be the store packs. If you guys know what I'm talking about, it's these packs over here. You come to special offers and you'll see like a store pack that usually has a coin platinum quick sell. Typically a cheap money option way of getting a lot of coins. So you'll be expecting that, as well as a new power pass. We'll probably end up seeing an 89 to 90 overall power pass, and maybe even another 85 to 86 or another 87 to 88. We'll probably cap at an 89 to 90 overall power pass, which is cool because you can get a lot of players with that. So guys, some players that are 89 to 90 may drop in value tomorrow just off the simple fact that people can now power up past them. So to give you guys some examples of that, if you have any of these players that you know that you might want to be power passing, maybe you sell them today while they're still high and the market's still expensive, because you can go ahead and take advantage of that, of course. So as we look on down here, these are some of the players you can be seeing. Now, it could be 89 to 90, remember? So let's start with the 90 overalls. These are going to be the more expensive ones you want to be worrying about, like Dan Marino, John Lynch, Richard Seymour, Junior Seau, even Bo Jackson potentially. Now, it could be, could it not be that? It's possible, but more than likely gonna be an 89 to 90. So you're gonna be able to get a lot of people here. Now the only ones that I'm not sure about is if they'll let you power pass LTDs just yet, because if so, Aaron Rodgers could take a big drop in value, as well as guys like Jamal Adams and stuff. So I don't know if that's the case, but he is dropping in value now as of the Series 2 news. So I don't know if people expect you to be able to put him in, because if you can use a power pass, which I don't see why you wouldn't be able to, just giving you like the side of caution here. If you aren't able to, then he'll stay fine. But if you are able to, you have to imagine that he's going to drop in price a decent amount. So the thing is with this is that just be wary of who you're going to use your power pass on. Guys like Denzel Ward, Lawrence Taylor is a great option, but that's going to drop a lot of people in the market, which is precisely why I haven't bought anything, because I'm kind of waiting for a Series 2 drop like that to go ahead and take advantage. Now, moving on from that, guys, beyond just power pass, you will get a lot of solo sequences. So on top of being on top of that, make sure you are catching up on your solos now, like your team of the week, your legends. Make sure you're playing your solos, because you're going to have a lot of solos to play tomorrow. More than likely, we might get a gauntlet or a journey, which we haven't gotten yet, which is kind of weird that we haven't gotten anything like that, because typically that's the first things we get. So we have none of the above there. Now, a gauntlet would be super cool, because that typically involves free players, free packs, free coins, and a bunch of free stuff, which is why I always do enjoy a good gauntlet solo challenge. Now, the only other thing that you guys want to be watching out too for is that tomorrow when this drops, there will be a new max mutt level grind. So make sure you're already maximum level 50. If you are not, make sure to go ahead and hit that, because the only thing worse than having to go from level 50 to 60 in a day to get all your rewards is going from level 30 to 60. Trust me, you want to make sure you are on top of everything and that you are ahead of the pack, because you want to be level 50 to 60. It's probably gonna take you a few hours. And apparently they did patch our endless level up glitch that we had. Not level up glitch, level up method, I should be calling it. So if that was gone and that took me a few hours to level up on, tomorrow could be a bit rougher than usual. But if it's only like a 4-hour grind, like I suspect, if you are level 50 already, that's not horrible. 4 hours is still a lot of time though. If you happen to already be level like, if you happen to be like level 30 or only level like 20, you're gonna be in for a rude awakening come level up grind tomorrow. So definitely go today, level up, do what you gotta do. Make sure you are ahead of the pack there, because you do not want to fall behind. Like, leveling up is horrible sometimes, especially like for me, I'm trying to do a video on it and stuff. But for you guys, just getting to those rewards can really feel like a pain sometimes. And of course, you want your 89 to 90 power pass. Why do you want it so soon? You have weekend league this weekend. You may want to get that free player up on your team as well, as get those free level up packs that can give you, usually level up packs can give you anywhere from 300,000 to 500,000 total on a new level up grind. So you can be looking at, again, another 500k to add to your weekend league squad. You could be looking at some free packs. They typically maybe give you free legend fantasy pack this time, or just some more gridiron packs, or all pro packs, or all pro packs, pro fantasy packs. You don't know what they're going to give you this time. They usually give you a few free packs as well. So hopefully, oh, and we do get our Andre Johnson leveled up as well, so stay tuned for that. Andre Johnson, and usually maybe Sam Mills, an extra upgraded thing as well for him, because that's typically what we can expect in a new Series 2 update. Now, guys, I'm going to open up this pack real quick for you guys. LTDs are in packs. I mean, not that I'll pull one from there, but you never know. I'm always going to test my luck. So the next thing that's super important is your Series 1 trophies. Remember, after a new series drops, your Series 1 trophies will be cut in half. So make sure you are going ahead and using those up. Now, here's the thing. If you have like 2,000 trophies and you're like, no, I want to save them for the next series, I'd rather use the 1,000 for like another token or something, you can go ahead and save it. But this year, there's no like master or anything, so I don't really see the point of saving it. In my opinion, if you have 2,000 trophies, after tomorrow, you will go down to about 1,000 trophies. They haven't confirmed that yet, but in years past, we always have lost half our trophies. So I imagine we're going to follow somewhat of a similar trend there. So make sure you are going ahead and taking care of your trophy situation before anything, because again, if they do cut your trophies in half, it would really suck for you to go ahead and lose out on some trophies. Now again, if you only have like 500 trophies, you know, you're gonna go down to 250, it's not horrible. If you only have 125 trophies like myself, you only go down to like 65-ish, 62.5, whatever you want to call it, however it rounds it. So that's not horrible, but again, if you have a ton of trophies, like 2-3k, you're gonna lose a lot of them. So maybe convert them, use the wheel of coins, maybe you want to pick up all your John Madden collectibles, which I would probably recommend. Maybe just get some 85 pluses, get some guaranteed value. And then of course, we do have exchange sets tomorrow, guys. So do not get rid of your 85 overall nat players. If you have 85 overall nat players like the NFL Epics, or if you have cards like some free nat players you got from solos, make sure you hold on to those, because remember, you will be able to go ahead and put those into the exchange set for 87 to 88 overall. So if you have your NFL Epics, it only takes three of them, you can get a free 87 to 88 tomorrow, which is pretty much a guaranteed 100 to 200k value, which is a super solid value and a farm account method as well, if you do go ahead and take advantage of that properly. So definitely make sure you're saving those, guys. So that pretty much covers that aspect of series trophies. We will be getting a lot of solos, like I said, gauntlets and other stuff. So like I said, make sure you're ahead of that. Now, you're going to have to choose tomorrow, level of grind versus gauntlet and all that stuff. If we do get all that, right? This is all speculation. But there's going to be solos and there's going to be level of grind. Probably get your level of grind done first, or maybe do it simultaneously. Do your solos while leveling up and then go finish up the grind afterwards, because I think the grind will be more worth it in terms of power pass and packs and stuff than it will be worth just getting your free player. But again, both are each to its own. Both are going to be solid for your team regardless of how you go ahead and take advantage of that. So just make sure you are staying on top of that. Now, remember, we do have probably the 50 coming soon, as well as potentially Most Feared and stuff. So we have a lot of stuff coming. So you want to get this stuff done quickly, because once 50 and stuff starts dropping, nothing's worse than, like, no content sucks, but content overload equally sucks, because then you start getting overwhelmed. You don't know what to do with solos. Remember, you have your Legend weekly solos to be playing for your tokens. You have your Team of the Week weekly solos for tokens. A lot of stuff for tokens you want to be focusing on as well. So make sure you are getting that done. And as far as Series 2, we may be even getting some other stuff as well. But again, that's what I'm going off years past. There could be more stuff. So in essence, to sum it all up, make sure your maximum level 50, so you can start the grind tomorrow. Make sure your solos are done and out of the way. Handle your Series 1 trophies, because you definitely don't want to be losing half. That is the case for tomorrow as well. There will be some team affinity stuff potentially you may have to play solos for again, so let's see how that works out. But guys, that pretty much wraps up today's video on what to do before Series 1, Series 2. Now, if you guys do want a chance to be shouted out in the next Poodle Squad, as per usual, go down below, like the video, turn on that noti bell, turn on all notifications next to it, and make sure to comment down below Poodle Squad. Now guys, if you need coins for anything for Series 2 to stock up tomorrow, to pick up some any of the new stuff, whatever's gonna be coming out in the next few weeks to pick up today's LTDs that they come out, head on over to muttreserve.com. Coins are half off, they're super cheap, and if you use code Poodle, you get an additional 15% off. So make sure you take advantage of any all of that. Guys, that's about it for the video. Hope you guys enjoy. Make sure to subscribe to the channel. Let's keep growing, boys. Thank you so much for watching. I'm out.